स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू स्टैंडर्ड 8 जनरल साइंस। दिस इज द फर्स्ट मॉड्यूल ऑफ द चैप्टर ह्यूमन बॉडी एंड ऑर्गन सिस्टम। द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ लर्निंग दिस चैप्टर। बाय लर्निंग दिस चैप्टर चिल्ड्रन, यू विल बी एबल टू डिफाइन व्हाट इज एन ऑर्गन सिस्टम। यू कैन एक्सप्लेन द टाइप्स ऑफ रेस्पिरेशन, list out the organs associated with the respiratory and circulatory system. You can give the functions of each organ involved in respiratory and circulatory system. You can understand the function of heart and gain knowledge about blood groups. Also understand the facts related to blood donation. Children, can you recollect from what the organs and organ systems are made up of? Yes, cells make up tissues, tissues make up organs, organs make up organ system. This setup we know that. Which organ systems are present in human body? Can you name a few? Yes, skeletal system, muscular system, respiratory, digestive, nervous system, excretory system, circulatory and reproductive system are some systems present in the human body. When we are asleep, that is, which process occur in our body during sound sleep? During sleep also, children, basic metabolism happens in the body. Which life processes occur continuously in our body without a break? If you see, processes like respiration, circulation, digestion and excretion occur continuously in the body. What is an organ system? Children, if we look at the body, different organs in our body are working in a group. So as many work can be carried out smoothly, so specific organs carry out specific steps. Take for example digestion. If we are swallowing a food, chewing happens in the mouth. Esophagus or the food pipe sends the food down. Stomach digest and absorb some of the nutrient. Intestine absorb some of the nutrient. Excretion happens in this large intestine. Liver helps in digestion by secreting some juice. Even pancreas also helps. Like that, specific organ carry out specific steps in all organ system. So group of organs working together to perform a specific function is called as organ system. What happens after eating food, children? After eating food, our body produces energy. So energy, we know it is essential to operate all the life processes in human body, and energy production occurs within the cells. So if you identify this one, this is nothing but our mitochondria. So this is the one that generates energy. To generate energy, cells need supply of soluble nutrients that we get from eating our food and oxygen from breathing for this purpose. So this supply takes place with the help of respiratory and circulatory systems. When you take respiration, respiration is of three types, that is external respiration, internal respiration and cellular respiration. So children, let us discuss these one by one in detail. First, external respiration. External respiration can be of two types, that is inspiration or inhalation and expiration or exhalation. During inhalation, air is taken through the nose and sent towards the lungs through trachea. So oxygen is transported throughout the body through blood during this process. During exhalation, the blood carries carbon dioxide from various parts of the body towards the lungs. And this carbon dioxide is given out during exhalation. So this process is called, that is, this inhalation and exhalation together called as external respiration. The second type, internal respiration, is exchange of gases between cells and tissue fluid is called as internal respiration. So when you take a cell, so there will be exchange of gases between the cells and the tissue fluid happens. So we know that oxygen is the one that moves from blood to the tissue, and carbon dioxide moves from tissue fluid to the blood. You can see this is the blood flow. You can follow the blue arrow, that is the oxygen that moves in, and the yellow arrow, the carbon dioxide that moves out to the blood flow. So this process is called internal respiration. What is cellular respiration? Dissolved nutrients like glucose that are slowly burned, you can say it is oxidized or digested with the help of oxygen, and energy is released in the form of a compound called ATP. ATP stands for adenosine triphosphate, and energy is stored in this compound. So this, as you can see, is generated by mitochondria. So mitochondria takes up glucose and produces energy in the form of ATP. Along with energy, as you can witness, waste materials like carbon dioxide and water vapor are also produced in this process. So this is the chemical equation explaining cellular respiration, that is C6H12O6, which is glucose, with the help of water releases carbon dioxide, water vapor and energy. So one molecule of glucose can give about 38 ATP. Okay children, now we will be learning about respiratory system. Let us discuss the organs involved in respiratory system. The organs involved in respiratory system are nose, pharynx, windpipe, lungs and diaphragm. Talking about nose, as we are very well aware, respiratory system and respiration begins with nose. Air is filtered with the help of hair and mucus present in the nose. If you see, this is the internal of nose. When you inhale air, so that with the help of hair and mucus is a sticky substance that is present in the nose. This filters the air out of dust and all, and the air is sent further to the windpipe. Children, air from the nose then passes through pharynx. We have two types of pipes that descends down the throat. One is food pipe and the other is windpipe. Both these food and windpipe originate in the pharynx. So if you see, windpipe is in front of the food pipe. So you can see both this is connected from mouth and nose. So this is the pharynx. You can see two pipes. The white striped one is the windpipe. It is located in front of this orange color food pipe that is connecting to the stomach. If you see, a lid is present at the front of the windpipe. So the lid closes during the passage of food. So this prevents the entry of food particle in the windpipe. So as we swallow the food, if you see, when food is being swallowed, this pipe closes, a lid like thing closes. So this prevents the entry of food to the windpipe. So otherwise, if the lid is not there, the windpipe will remain open. Then the air passes through the pharynx and then into the windpipe and further to the lungs. So children, many of you have experienced this choking of food. Why this happens? See, when you swallow the food, when you chew the food in the mouth and then swallow, we know the windpipe should close so that the food will pass through the food pipe. But at times, what happens, instead of food entering the food pipe, it mistakenly enters the windpipe. This normally happens when we speak while eating the food. So what happened? This misentry will happen to choking. So choking sometimes may lead to very serious trouble. So that is why it is advised not to speak while eating food. The next organ in the respiratory system is, children, windpipe, otherwise called as trachea, as you can see here. Windpipe, if you see, it is swollen at the beginning due to the presence of the voice box or sound box. So it descends and bifurcates into two in the thorax. Bifurcates is dividing into two. One branch enters the right lung and the other one enters the left lung. The next important organ in the respiratory system is lungs. Lung is present on either side of the heart in the thoracic cavity. So this is the thoracic cavity, and a lung is present on either side of the heart. Maximum area of thoracic cavity is occupied by lungs. As you can see, it occupies the maximum area of thoracic cavity, and they cover maximum part of the heart. Each lung, if you see, it has a double layer covering, and this covering is called as pleura. So lungs, as you see, they are like an elastic sponge. So they stretch while we breathing. This is the common thing that we experience while we breathe. We can easily monitor the movement of lungs while we breathing. Our chest goes up and down. This is because of the elastic nature of the lung that can stretch very much while breathing. They are made up of many small compartment called alveoli. So this is the lung. As you can see, they are made up of many small compartment. It looks like a bunch of grapes. So rich network of capillaries. Capillaries are very small blood vessels, the things that you are seeing in blue and red, all are capillaries. Rich network of capillaries are present around each alveoli. We can understand very well why this is, because this is where gaseous exchange happens, that is intake of oxygen to the blood flow and output of carbon dioxide from the blood happens here. So each alveoli has rich network of capillaries. So the wall of alveoli and the capillaries are extremely thin so that the gaseous exchange can be made faster. So gaseous exchange can take easily across the walls. As you can see, so this is the alveolar sac, this is the alveoli. You can see in the blood gases, oxygen and carbon dioxide being exchanged. You can see carbon dioxide and oxygen exchange happens in the alveolar sac. Let us witness the exchange of gases in the lungs in detail. So gaseous exchange occur continuously in alveoli because breathing happens continuously. We know that very well. So blood contains an iron-rich protein called hemoglobin. This hemoglobin is present in the red blood cells of the blood. As you can see, these are called red blood cells. These blood cells contain, as you can witness, these red dots are nothing but iron, and this thread-like thing is the protein hemoglobin. This red color is due to the presence of iron in hemoglobin. So what is the purpose of this? So hemoglobin has the capacity to absorb only oxygen. So hemoglobin will bind only to oxygen. So this helps in absorption of oxygen from air within alveoli. Because while we are breathing, we know that we are breathing all the gases that is present in the air. And our lungs also do not segregate between oxygen and other gases. The understanding happens here in the RBC. So this red blood cell will have this protein hemoglobin. This hemoglobin only can take in oxygen. As children, you can see in this picture. So this is dark red. When it absorbs oxygen, the RBC becomes bright red. You can see the change. While coming with carbon dioxide, this RBC is somewhat darker, but when it absorbs oxygen, you can see it is changing to bright red. So that is the difference between oxygenated blood and deoxygenated blood. Thus, the oxygen is taken into the blood and carbon dioxide, as you can see, it is eliminated from the blood and it can be given out by exhalation process. The next organ involved in respiration is diaphragm. Diaphragm is a muscular partition at the base of thoracic cage. It is present between thoracic cavity and the abdominal cavity. Children, as you can see, this is the thoracic cavity, this is abdominal cavity. You can see diaphragm shaped like a parachute that is present between thoracic cavity and abdominal cavity. So, simultaneous rising up of ribs and lowering of diaphragm causes the decrease in pressure in lungs. That is, as you can see, when you inhale, the diaphragm moves down. So, this creates decrease in pressure in the lungs. So, due to the decrease in pressure, the lungs can draw more air from outside. So, due to this, the air moves into the lungs through nose, and when ribs return to their original position and diaphragm rises, the pressure increases on the lungs. So, due to this, the air moves out through nose. So, continuous upward and downward movement of the diaphragm is necessary for breathing. I think you liked this process of respiration, children. Let us summarize the points. Different organs in our body are working in group so as to smoothly carry out various life processes. Group of organs working together to perform a specific function is called as organ system. Nutrients and oxygen supply takes place with the help of respiratory and circulatory systems. Respiration happens via three steps, that is external, internal and cellular respiration. Respiratory system consists of organs like nose, pharynx, windpipe, lungs and diaphragm. Respiratory system and respiration begins with nose as filtered with the help of hair and mucus present in the nose. Food pipe and windpipe originate in the pharynx. The lid at the beginning of windpipe closes during passing of food into food pipe and thereby normally prevents the entry of food particles into windpipe. Windpipe bifurcates in the thorax. One branch enters the right lung and the other into the left lung. A lung is present on either side of heart in thoracic cavity. Each lung has double layered covering. Lungs are made up of many small compartments called alveoli. Rich network of capillaries is present around each alveolus. Gaseous exchange occurs continuously while blood is circulating around the alveoli. A muscular partition present at the base of thoracic cage is called as diaphragm. Continuous upward and downward movement of diaphragm is necessary to bring about breathing. So children, there are so many interesting things that to be learned in the chapter that we will discuss in the coming module. Until then, thank you.